Even if they are the most dangerous weapons ever created, nuclear weapons still don't scare some people. So here are 5 nuclear detonations that went wrong. Number 5. Starfish Prime. Starfish Prime was a high-altitude nuclear test conducted by the United States on the 9th of July, 1962. A Thor rocket carrying a W-49 thermonuclear warhead was launched from the Johnson Island in the Pacific Ocean. 9 seconds after 11 p.m. Honolulu time, the Starfish Prime test was successfully detonated at an altitude of 400 kilometers. It caused an electromagnetic pulse which was far larger than expected, so much larger that it drove much of the instrumentation off scale. The pulse caused electrical damage in Hawaii about 1,445 kilometers away from the detonation point, knocking out about 300 streetlights, setting off numerous burglar alarms, and damaging a telephone company microwave link. The damage to the microwave link shut down telephone calls from the Hawaii Islands. The flash created by the explosion could be seen from over 1,500 kilometers away. This is a photo of the explosion as seen through the clouds from Honolulu, Hawaii. It is thought that the explosion produced an yield equivalent to 1.4 megatons of TNT. Here you can see the footage. Number 4. Standing under a nuke. On the 19th of July 1957, 6 men, including the cameraman, stood at ground zero of a nuclear test at the Nevada test site. The explosion occurred over 3,000 meters above the ground and was equivalent to 2 kilotons of TNT. The 5 volunteers and the cameraman, who wasn't a volunteer, stood under the explosion without any safety gear, though the cameraman asked for protection but didn't get any. The purpose of the test was to show US citizens that they had nothing to fear about nukes. The bomb exploded, creating a bright light and powerful sound wave that scared the 6 men. Everything was thought to be fine until they all got cancer, though most of them lived their lives until their 80s. It is kind of disappointing that none of them got any superpowers and turned into Hulks.
We felt a heat pulse, a very bright light, a fireball. It is red, the sky looks black about it, it is boiling above us there. It is rapidly losing its color. There is the ground wave. It is over, folks. It will happen. The mountains are vibrating.
Number 3. Lake Chagan. In 1965, the Soviets had the brilliant idea to create a lake by using a nuke. The nuclear test occurred at the Semipalatinsk test site in Kazakhstan. Chagan's yield was equivalent to 140 kilotons of TNT and meant to produce a large conical crater suitable for a lake. The resultant lake has a diameter of 408 meters and is 100 meters deep. Afterwards, the Soviets dug a channel between the river and the crater and let gravity do its thing. Unfortunately, they forgot an elementary thing, radiation. Actually, even nowadays, Lake Chagan is still radioactive. I'm presuming that that's where they get their fish for sci-fi movies. Number 2. Storax, Sedan. Sedan was a shallow underground nuclear test conducted at the Nevada test site on the 6th of July 1962 as part of Operation Plowshare. It was a program to investigate the use of nuclear weapons for mining, cratering, and other civilian purposes. The explosive device was lowered into a shaft drilled into the desert alluvium 194 meters deep. The fusion fission blast had a yield equivalent to 104 kilotons of TNT and lifted a dome of earth 90 meters above the desert floor before it vented at 3 seconds after detonation. The explosion displaced more than 11 million tons of soil. The Sedan shot resulted in an enormous radioactive cloud that separated into 2 plumes rising to 3 kilometers and 4.9 kilometers. The cloud flew as far as 1,000 kilometers away, spreading radioactive dust over Iowa, Nebraska, Illinois, and South Dakota. This one explosion accounts for 7% of the entire nuclear fallout that has ever hit the United States. The Sedan crater is the largest man-made crater in the United States, and it is listed in the National Register of Historic Places.
Sedan was detonated at 10 a.m., July 6, 1962. This is a view taken from the top of a 1,500-foot tower, located 6 miles from ground zero.
Number 1. The nuke that almost exploded over North Carolina. In 1961, a B-52 bomber went into a tailspin and crashed over North Carolina while carrying two nukes with the power of 3 to 4 megatons, each 260 times as powerful as the one that was dropped on Hiroshima. The pilots threw them away before crashing into a farmland, though one of the nukes was armed. When the bomb was dropped, three of the four arming mechanisms activated, causing it to execute many of the steps needed to arm itself, such as charging the firing capacitors and, luckily, deploying a 100-foot diameter parachute which allowed the bomb to hit the ground with little damage. Here you can see one of the nuclear weapons at Goldsboro, largely intact, with its parachute still attached. The bomb was large enough to have a 100% kill zone of 23 kilometers. Enjoying our videos? Make sure to click on the subscribe button in the top right corner. Share this video with your friends and help us grow. Check out our Facebook and Twitter pages by clicking on these logos.